Welcome to another video. In this video, I am making my favorite salad. This is a Mexican three bean salad. And I'm starting by opening the peppers, getting them ready to be chopped. I use this small knife because everything else is in the dishwasher. So I slice off the top and pull the middle out with the seeds. They don't come out all the time very easily, but in the cutting process I will be cleaning the peppers. One by one, taking every seed out from the peppers. And putting the pepper aside, and just like that. Some peppers needed to be cut in quarters to access the seeds better, and others could be cut in just half. Looks good. And now I'm just cleaning the surface to make sure I have enough space for slicing the peppers into thin strips and then slowly and gently cutting them perpendicularly. This knife is relatively sharp, but not ideal. I take my time doing the slicing. I know that this is not the most efficient way of doing that, but the goal for this recipe was not necessarily to do it the most efficient way, but to create some sort of relaxation. I also try to be present when making food. Smelling it and touching it, hearing the sounds, just what you're hearing. But really, I should have used a much larger knife. Not very convenient to do it this way. This is a carving knife that is good to use for smaller jobs, but in this case, a regular knife would have been better. With that said, I still like to slice my peppers and I feel like I am in control of where the knife goes. The slices for this recipe should be smaller than bite size because I am incorporating beans that you see to the right into the recipe as a main ingredient. And the sizes of peppers will be similar, should be rather similar to the size of beans. Alright, there we go. That's the last portion of green peppers. Now, one interesting fact that I learned is that green peppers are just premature, different color paper peppers. So all green peppers eventually turn into a different color. Red or yellow or another color. But I like green peppers because they have a little bit of a slight bitter taste. Now, just placing all the peppers into the glass bowl and starting on a red onion. First, need to peel it, so I cut both ends and then slice the top cover. Sometimes it's hard to find the ends, but there we go. And now I'll cut it in half, because I'm going to use one half only. And then I'm getting a larger knife because I'm sick and tired of using the small one. Okay. There we go. Now we're talking here. I'm just slowly slicing the onion across this way. About 3 to 4 millimeters in width. Holding the onion steadily so that it does not fall apart. Now I'm turning it over and trying to cut it across to get those diced size of onion. This is a sweeter version of regular onion, so, but I still want to taste some of it. And the last pieces are the hardest. And I just do some quick slicing of separate onion pieces that are too long to be placed in a cell. All done. Now, just separating it and putting on top of the green pepper. There we go. Alright. I'm just scooping it up to the area of compostable food waste. And now I'm going to open the cans. This is red beans from Trader Joe's, and this is Great Northern beans. These are like whitish type of beans. also from Trader Joe's, and these are, I believe, also organic. And finally, black beans, organic black beans. This knife, because the can opener didn't do a great job. There we go. Just bend it over like that. Be careful if you do that with your hand. And finally the last third can. Now I want to wash them off. Make sure that every single bean is out. It's a little bit difficult. So, I rinse it with water, the can itself, so the beans can easily come out. But in this case, I'm struggling, so I'm gonna use my knife. Kind of get it out. There we go. They are going to come out much better. And one more rinse. Perfect. Putting it aside. Next, just rinsing the beans and themselves from any additional salt or whatever liquid they were stored in, so that any flavor that beans absorb are flavors from the salad dressing. And drain it nicely so that no water gets in the salad. Next can. This one is easier to come out. One more rinse. And we're good to go. And this can rinse very thoroughly. Making sure that everything is nice and condiment-free or preservative-free. You can certainly use the liquid or just drain the liquid without washing, but I prefer to wash them. And black beans finally. They're smaller in size, so it takes a little bit longer to wash them off. Perfect. And now I am just draining this off one more time and putting the beans in the salad bowl. Perfect. Next. My corn. This is frozen corn. Opening this up and putting almost the whole package, leaving some behind for sure. And now we're going to focus on the actual dressing. So I am getting my measuring cup and my olive oil, pouring 1/3 cup of olive oil into the cup and in this little glass mason jar. And then I am going to take a little bit of red wine vinegar and pour just about half of that, a little bit more. Great, switching to my limes. I had two limes that I used before, so I have two halves that I'm going to use for this recipe. Squeezing the limes and the second one. Just like that. That's enough. I usually also double squeeze in case something is left. I don't like to waste food. Okay. Next thing is pouring the lime juice into the mason jar. Perfect. And now the seasonings. Very important part in any salad. Some chili powder. This is about half a teaspoon. Some of the cumin, a little bit more, and next I'm taking a little bit of salt and putting right in there. I will add a little bit more of salt later, but first I want just a little bit. Now some black pepper. No science to it when it comes to black pepper. And then Italian seasoning. Just a little bit for flavor. Now I'm going to chop some, peel and chop some garlic. Have a little bit more here. Peeling garlic is not my strength. For some reason I like to do it the hard way. I know people just squeeze it with their knife and it's all ready to go. But not in my case. Somehow I like to peel it one by one. Slowly. Just like that, and I have about 4 cloves of garlic that are ready to be cut. And this is when this knife is really handy for these smaller jobs. Typically, I would take my garlic roller, which chops garlic very well, but for this video, I decided to incorporate some cutting sounds because I know some people like that. So I cut each perpendicularly, one by one, about 1 millimeter in width. It's very easy to use this knife for cutting garlic, but ultimately I will want to switch to a larger one. There we go. Now just doing a finer job cutting it. Again, remember I'm not a professional at this, so it might not look pretty, but it certainly does the job. As I'm finishing up the finer cutting, I'm gonna just go ahead and put it in the mason jar using my knife. Okay, that's almost it. Okay. Just gonna wipe my hand with it. And now it's time to do a little bit of mixing. So I use my spoon to mix everything in the mason jar, dilute salt, and break that oil-vinegar separation. Going to taste a little bit of it to see what's missing. Looks like maybe a little bit of salt is needed. Let's add some salt. Usually I add about 1 tablespoon. I added probably about 2 teaspoons right now. Mixing a little bit more, stirring it to create an even consistency. I really like this spoon. Alright, bringing the salad right here and pouring dressing right over it like that. And now it's time to mix the salad. I'm grabbing my plastic large spoon and I'm going to mix it from bottom to the top. Bottom to the top and kind of swirl it so that everything is well incorporated into the salad. You see how beautiful the colors are. I usually like to add 1 green and 1 red salad pepper, but this time I only had 2 green ones. Usually the salad turns out even more colorful. Again, I want to really incorporate all the ingredients well, so that they're a nice consistency. And as I mix the salad, I am tasting it a little bit here and there to see what's missing. And so now I'm thinking to add a little bit more of acidity. So I have some red wine vinegar, and I'm just going to mix it a little bit more. Typically I would add about 1/2 of the lemon juice into the salad, but unfortunately I don't have any lemons in my refrigerator today. But it feels like, it tastes like it's still missing something. Maybe a little bit more acidity. Now red wine, maybe just a little bit. I also have have some apple cider vinegar. I'm going to use that. And just shaking it a little bit. Okay, just a tiny bit. It also will add some sweetness to the salad. Oh, I think it's going to be perfect. Alright. Well, I think this is a couple of meals for my week. This is my meal prepping. Looks great.